trip is overcoming the impossible in speech pathology and audiology. This could be impossible with clients. Sometimes we feel challenged. It could be impossible with our caseload if we're in the schools or even private practice. It could be impossible maybe we're in a work situation that we feel is so impossible. It could be impossible in school because we never feel like we're going to fit done. So today, I'm going to bring you the five P's. Passion, perseverance, person-centered therapy, potential, and possibilities. Let's get started and pack that suitcase. Passion. According to Catherine Russell Rich in the O magazine, she defines passion as spirit-jolting, life-infusing. It's the fearless, urgent, one-on-one connection between you, a thing, an idea, a challenge, another person. Passion is energy. We hear it all the time. Go after your passion. But what does that mean? Simply said, it means love what you do. Work doesn't feel like work. I've been in situations where I've been in jobs where I didn't particularly like, and it was hard to go to work, and I felt defeated, and I felt upset. And now things are different. I love to teach public speaking. I love to work in my private practice. And most of all, I love being able to speak at speaking engagements like this. I'm doing my passion. Sometimes I can't believe what I'm doing. It doesn't feel like work because it's fun and rewarding. Okay, maybe not writing those evaluations. Those take a long time. So we also have to help our clients find their passion for talking. It doesn't matter if it's stuttering, articulation, client had a stroke, whatever it is. That passion for talking gets squeezed out by the disorder. I once had a client that loved to talk about hermit crabs. And so that year, I learned so much about hermit crabs. I never knew so much about hermit crabs. When he talked about hermit crabs, he was so excited about talking about hermit crabs that the stuttering, it was there. But it didn't matter. It didn't hold him back. Before, he wouldn't want to talk because I don't want to talk about something that I'm not excited about. When I first started to do public speaking, I would go around and talk to Kiwanis and mothers groups, and I would talk about how children learn to talk. And for me, that process was so passionate and so exciting that I was nervous, but I would forget about my nervousness about public speaking and I would forget about my stuttering. It was still there, but it no longer ran the roost. So we need to find our passion. We need to help our clients find that passion for talking. We're not done. Person-centered therapy, our third component. We need to look beyond the impairment and see the person. As a kid who stuttered, I felt like a mouth. Okay, so a cute little mouth, but a mouth. Everybody was quivered around this, but nobody knew to be concerned about what was going on inside. Inside, I felt like I was dying. I felt like I was not able to share my feelings. I was not able to do what I wanted to do because of my stuttering. I felt so defeated. Remember that the person inside came before the disorder. When we see the person first, we honor their spirit. Then we use our expertise in speech pathology and audiology to be able to help them. Get to know that person first. Know what makes them tick. Know what's exciting, what they like to talk about, and what's boring for them. So we can find a treatment plan that honors their person. When we take that time to develop a relationship and show them that they're important, we honor who they are. And when we do this, guess what? We secretly give them permission to be who they are. disorder or not. Isn't that what we want?
Okay.
Fourth one. We're getting there. I promise. Potential. So I want you to take a minute and imagine a briefcase or a purse, either one, and imagine it's lined black inside. And so you see zippered sections in there. Sorry. My random movements that are causing trouble right now. Can you all hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay. My nice Italian voice is paying off after all. Good. Okay. So I want you to imagine that briefcase or that purse, and it's black inside, and there's a zippered section in there, and you've always noticed it, but guess what? You never looked inside, and when you go to look inside, you see that there's a check for $1 million,
which it's always been there, but you never really looked.
Okay, and you might be thinking, well, what does this have to do with communication? What does this have to do with us? Well, lurking deep inside in people who have communication disorders is their potential to be a confident communicator. And so we, as speech pathologists and audiologists, we need to find how to unearth this, how to expose this. It's our job to help them find their potential. I, as a kid who stuttered, I had the potential. I just didn't know. I only knew not being able to do things, couldn't do it, so nothing was possible. So I ask you to think about potential.
All right, we're getting there. Number five. Okay, possibilities.
So sometimes, I don't know about you, but we pack a lot of impossibilities. This will be impossible. I can't do this. I can't talk to my boss about that. I can't tell them that I can't do 75 on that caseload. I can't do that. There's lots of impossibilities. For me, being a public speaker was the biggest impossibility because of my stuttering. Never in a million years, as a kid who severely stuttered, did I ever believe that I would be so blessed with the opportunities that I do now on a regular basis. The impossible became very possible when 16 years ago, I decided to open my private practice, and I decided to go do some presentations. I went to Kiwanis Clubs, Lions Clubs, I'm not sure, any service organization that would have me come speak. And I would go there, and in the back of my mind, I thought, oh my gosh, I stutter. They're never going to, I'm like advertising and doing PR. They're going to run the other way. And it was really hard at times. I sat in my car when I was done and cried. And I thought, how can I do this? But then something connected, and it became my passion. I never set out to do this. I just thought I was getting some advertisement. But then became this passion. And so then I started to do half day, whole day, 3 day, seminar companies, speaking all over the country. So I ask you today to dream of impossibilities for you and your clients. It's just more fun that way. I feel like if you feel like things are impossible in work with clients, have the courage to make a change. Have the courage to think a little bit differently. Have the courage to do something a little bit differently. Because when we do that, we get different results.
So, guess what? We talked about our five P's. We talked about passion. We talked about perseverance, person-centered therapy, potential, and possibilities. I ask you to pack these five P's when you go back to school, work,
wherever you go, wherever your work setting leads you. I ask you to pack these five P's. And I ask you, speech pathologists, audiologists, students of New Mexico, to go out there and believe the impossible for you
In the words of Michael Phelps, he said, "I wouldn't say anything is impossible. I think everything is possible as long as you put your mind to it and put the work and the time in it. Make our world a different place because of your touch in speech pathology and audiology. My friends, I wish you lots of impossibilities turning into possibles. Thank you so much."